All right. Good morning, good evening, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, wherever you may be in this fantastic world of ours. Hi, and welcome back to The Shit Show. My name's Didi, and, well, today I have been advised to say that I am driving a spaceship. So, today, that's what I'm doing, I'm captaining a spaceship. We're back on nights. This is my first day back, and I really need to sort my recording out, I really do. I used to record a couple of weeks in advance, so I had something to fall back on, and I'm not doing that anymore. So, it's Monday today. I'm in work Monday, Wednesday, Thursday night. 6 o'clock start tonight. Off tomorrow. Wednesday, 8 o'clock. Thursday, 8 o'clock. That's what we're doing. 3 nights this week. I'm quite happy with that. I can live off that kind of money. So don't bother me. I get to do the stuff that I want to do, you know what I mean? We've got a couple of things I need to explain to you guys, because there's some people that are just not really picking things up very well. Do you know what I mean? Some people I think are a little bit confused. I don't know what that is with. I don't know how you could possibly be confused. I mean, there's people in the chat that stick up for me and say these things, but I need to say it out on camera. I really wanted to do it now, but if I do it now, there's not going to be any content really for the video. I am actually smashing some bass tonight. I've got to go down to Middlewich with a single decker trailer, which is no the 529, which we're going to go and pick up in a minute. I've got to go down to Middlewich, that's XPO at Middlewich. I've not even put my satellite on. I need to put my satellite navigation on, because I'm a steering wheel attendant and don't know where the flap I'm going. Where's fag lighter in here? I'm in a 68 plate MAN. Seriously, I just cannot get away from MANs at the moment. I am literally living in them. It's all I'm driving. Just driving MANs everywhere. Anyway, so we've got to go down to COVID. Get a bit of spit on me, you lad. Get a bit of lube. Shut up, Didi. Don't start already, you fool. Don't start already. Right. Oh, sugar. Right, you just do what you should do as a sat nav and just stay there. That's your only job in life, just stay there. Agree, I'm using a Garmin Diesel 580. That's what I'm using. And I always have it set to 16.4. Unless I'm carrying a double, which I'll change it later to 16.3. I always have it set to 16.4, even if I'm only having a single. It's just better being safe than sorry, innit? You know what I mean? That's just my personal opinion. Make sure your height indicator is correct in the cab, because that is a legal requirement. But your sat nav, keep it at whatever you want. If you're running a normal single decker trailer, keep it at 16 foot. You're never going to be within a foot and a half of bridges. You know what I mean? Whatever. There's your tips for you. I keep getting asked what sat nav I use. That's what I use. Garmin Diesel 580. I've used it for ages. I've used it since I started driving. So yeah. What was the app that I used called? Oh, I can't remember. I used an app when I first started. I paid like $7.99 a month for it. I can't remember what it was called, but it was crap. It was bizballs. Anyway, right, get to the point, lad. Picking up 529, we're taking it down to Middlewich. That's XPO at Middlewich. I need to Google it and find out where it actually is, because I've not got an address of it, believe it or not. So we're gonna drop the single, maybe on a bay. If it's on a bay, I'll show you. Pick up a double, take the double down to Dunstable. Park that in a bit of a tight yard. I'll show you that. Got to reverse it in between two brick columns. It's cool. It's decent. But I feel like I've not drove a truck for ages. It's only been like 5 days. I feel like I've not drove for ages. Anyway, and then get that loaded, unloaded and reloaded. Take it back to Middlewich. Park it up at Middlewich. Pick up an empty single decker and bring that up here. Park that up, and that's my night done. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to get moving. But first of all, we need to go and get a
trailer.
That one. 529. What we're after. I've got a camera on my head, and there's a guy parked straight facing the trailer, aren't you? Great. Way to make yourself look like a bigger todger than you really are, Didi lad. Well done. Sure. Cheers, Mush. Thanks, Dig Daddy-o. So, let's pick up said trailer. Let's get a handle. We need a sticky thing. Our thing. KHB 529.
Papa Hotel Bravo 529. Stick it in reverse. And let's go down on suspension. I can't hear nothing. Is it working? I can hear something. We're about halfway under. Let's lift it up. Fifth wheel has made contact with said trailer. We're still going up, so we'll keep going up so we don't smash the shit out of the trailer legs. And then, nice and gently, because this is not a daft gearbox, we can gently roll, click into place, just like so. We shall put it into drive, do two tug tests. One, how do you do a tug test? Just don't floor it, just tickle it, it doesn't go anywhere. Even if you just, you know, just doesn't go anywhere. So just tickle it a bit. Make sure your handbrake's on. Make sure you're in neutral. I'm gonna turn the leveler off just so it doesn't adjust accidentally. And I'm just gonna put the side lights on. Because this thing, what am I pressing? Hazard lights for you donkey. Pressing steering wheel thing. That's what I should have been pressing. And then with that thought, jump out, taking our registration plate with us. Oof! Registration plate with us. Overall height, 13 foot 9 and a half. So when you're doing your test, or when you're doing a driving assessment, pardon me, I'm sorry, I think I just headbutted you then, didn't I? Put dog clip off. That's not going anywhere at all. Go around yonder. When you're doing a driving assessment, I forgot what the first thing I told Nessa when she was doing hers. Give her two pieces of advice. I can't remember what the first one was, I do apologise. But the second one was, make sure you check your trailer height and make sure you remember it and change it. That's one thing on assessments they really drill into you, because bridge strikes are like the naughtiest thing you can do in a HGV. Literally. You should not be hitting bridges. Simple as that, you just shouldn't. I don't know if you can see this or not, but like I've said, no, that's the wrong one, so you don't go in. If you get it wrong, don't go in. So that's the secondary one. Secondary in, here to cross over that. Don't like it on the cross. Freaks me out. When you put them on, just give them a little twist. Don't even think you've done anything to be fair. They're not going to accidentally magically fall off. Yeah, 13 foot 9 and a half. Oh, we'll check your side lights as we walk down the good days. If you want to take the trailer with you, you look to the road ahead. If you want to leave it behind, you look behind it and glad to see back here, you see. So you know when you come to your trailer, if you want to check it with you, you look to the road ahead where you wind your legs and it'll come with you. That's plan anyway. Wind it up, 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 up. And then trailer brake on. If it starts rolling, you forgot your handbrake, you're an idiot. Pull that out quick. Don't get run over, don't get squished. Oh yes. It's brand new this trailer. It's a minter. Tires are spankers. Happy days. We're sealed. That's the wrong seal number. That is the wrong seal number. I'm not just wrote down 67427. The paperwork says 538 or something like that. So we're gonna have to go and discuss that. We're gonna have to go in and discuss it. That's not cool. God damn it. Brand spanker, I like it. I like it a lot. Okay, excuse me. So we're pretty much done, Eth. Just don't forget the simple and forgettable task
changing. Changing this. 2, 13, 4.
I think that's what I said, didn't I? Is that what I said? I can't even remember. Friggin' forgot me.
13, 9.5.
Shit. Double check, son. Double check.
Bloody 13.4.
You friggin' furry. Oh, Christ. I've got all the way around. My fingers are killing me. 13, 9.5. Talk about taking piss. Right, 13.10. That's happy days. Right, I'm going to look up and not show you this because you're not allowed to see this, but yeah, that sale number's wrong. 5638. Oh no, it's changed it. 7427. Sale number's right. It's been changed manually, so I need to change it on my sheet. Sale number 7427. Seven, four, two, seven. Okay, so that's how I'm hitching up to my trail again for the millionth time. Right, now I need to find where the flipping flapper flap I'm going, because I don't even really know, mate. I really don't. Look at that there. XPO middle vich. XPO earth. I remember earth. Right, CW10. CW10. Zero, Quebec, Jacko. Who the frig's Jacko? Just to show you, I will, how do I do it now? Cancel. Oh, we back, settings. Vehicle profile, 16 foot. I have it set at. So you see that 2.55 meters wide, 16 foot, 16 meters long, 44 ton. They're my settings. They're what I run at. And I just leave it at that. View map. We're cracking on. It's so now we're down to Middle Vich. So the seal's right. So we're going to get out of here. We're going to get out of here. I'll come back to you when we get to Middle Vich itself. We'll have 5 minutes chitty chatty when we get down there. He's going to the same place as me and he's going to get there before me. And I'm going to have to wait for him to be unloaded. It's going to be well annoying. It's going to make my day even longer. Get back to you when we get to Middle Vich. Talk to you soon, ladies and gents. Tatty bye. Oh yeah, I almost forgot. When you've got your trailer, don't forget to set your ride height back to what it should be. Don't ride with it, arsehole. Because it's just not cool, it's not professional, don't look good. Ride IT is now set back to normal. Now we can, literally, get on the way to Middle Vich. Ciao for now. Ding, dang, douches. We're just coming off the M6 at junction something or other. Towards, well, Middle Vich, because that's where I told you I was going. Would you want to believe it? Bet you wouldn't, would you? So, right. Yeah, drove here, got here, we're here, we're nearly there. Easy, peasy, lemon squeezy. No problemo. Don't write anyone off at roundabout, that would be a small dogtastrophe. If I could, you know. Get out any time before next November, that'd be absolutely fan-bloody-tastic, thanks. Right, so, what I want to talk about, one of the things I want to talk about right now, there's two things I think that I can think about, two things that I think need discussing, because some people just don't think about them. And numero uno is, for Christ's sake people, I am an agency driver. Please, for the people that just don't get it, I'm an agency driver. I move around. I don't stay in one place doing one job with one company forever. That's why I'm not at Hermes right now. If I want to go back to Hermes, I can go. But I'm just mooching around. I'm just doing my own thing. The variety is nice. The agency I'm working for at the moment is crying out for drivers in the Manchester, Oldham, Rochdale area. Days, nights, class two, class one, 6 months experience, class two will take new pass drivers. I said this in my last one. If you want to be given his details, drop me a DM on Instagram and I'll give you his details. He's crying out for drivers. So he's an awesome guy. This is why I commute as far as I do, because he's a really good lad. The guy that runs the agency is a top bloke. He's got respect for me, so well, it's mutual respect. Do you know what I mean? I had a problem last Friday. Phoned him up, told him, not a problem, don't worry, I'll sort it for you. I phoned up the company I was working for, don't worry, we'll sort it, not an issue. They changed my run round a little bit, and I got back when I needed to get back. Bang on, absolutely awesome. If I don't like a shift start time, I just say I don't want to do it. You know, I've kind of told him my boundaries. I think I'm going to have to change that and just suck it up and get them done, because I've promised I'll take my kids on holiday in August. If I'm bad, I thought get saving for that end. But yeah, I'm an agency driver. Please, will you please, for the love of Christ, let that sink into your FOD. I'm an agency driver. I like moving around. I don't like staying at one company because it bores the living daylights out of me. To be fair, Downton's was decent. I enjoyed Downton's because I went to a different place every day. I was all over the show. I enjoyed that, but still, I was still doing the exact same job. I was still taking insulation wherever it was. And then when I was coming back, it was always paper back up to Accrington. So even though it was decent, because I was going somewhere new in the morning, I was still doing paper every day. Going back doing paper. Gets boring, and I'm not into that. I don't do that. That's just not my style of work. That's not what I like. I don't like it, so I just don't do it. I like mooching around. I like doing something different. I like going to different companies. I like driving different units. I don't really care whether they're dirty or clean. I really could not give a monkey's testicle. Don't care. I just get in it. As long as it works and it's safe, get in it, I drive it, I don't care. So please, for the love of God, please, please, will you just understand that I'm on an agency? So stop saying things like, he might sell down soon and actually find a job that they want to keep him. I got asked if I'd stay at that last place on days permanent. And I said no. Because I didn't want to. You know what I mean? He said, oh, good lad, you proper hard working. You're flying, aren't you? And I'm like, well, I don't mess about. You know what I mean? I get my job done and I go home. I'm not in it for scraping out 15-hour shifts anymore. I don't want to do it. I really don't. An 8-hour shift is fine for me now. I'm happy with a flat dead standard. 8-hour rate, 8-hour day, done. Happy days. I'm not interested in 15-hour shifts anymore. I can't be bothered with them. And I don't need them. If I needed them, I'd probably do them. But I really don't need them. So I don't want to do them. So get me a Euro Central, Motherwell, Hermes, Bosch, Bosch, turn round, Bosch, Bosch, done, finish, go home. That's what I'm into now. Do you know what I mean? It's like this, what I'm doing now, trunking work. Piece of cake. I mean, this, coming here, I've never done this before, where I've had to come here and then go to Dunstable. This is probably going to add on about, what, over the course of the night, probably about an hour onto my night. But I started at 6, so if it's an 11-hour shift, at least I'll be getting back to the yard at 5. Do you know what I mean? Where am I going now? I'm bad for get well lost. No, I'm straight up, lad. Straight up. Oh, yeah, if you're not following me on Instagram, go and follow me. I'm going to start putting more normal stuff on there, day-to-day life stuff, pictures of me, pictures of my kids, pictures of where I go. I know it's classed as a business account, but honestly, I'm bored of seeing pictures of trucks and cars on my Instagram. You know what I mean? I'm bored of seeing it. I'm not going to lie. So, we're here. Expo. X-ray Papa Octopus. That's the flow of this week's vlog. It's spelling everything phonetically incorrectly. Don't hit gate, lad. That'll never work. Right, camera, front camera, go. Bye! can't have that front camera on. Right, what I'm actually going to do is do for you is we're gonna talk to this man now about a cat. I'm going to talk to him about a dog because at the moment he's not got up and said hello. So we'll talk to him about a cat, and then I'll see where he wants me to put it. I think he's putting me on a. If he wants me to put it on a bay, I'll show you what I'm doing. I'll show you what I'm doing. And then we're picking up a double decker. Don't forget to change height marker. It's a legal requirement. You need to change height marker when you're getting that double decker. Oh yeah, and the number plate thing. I don't put the number plate on straight after doing the kingpin because you can't check your lights. That's just my personal preference. Stick to blank when you're first starting out. When you've got your own method of doing it, crack on and do it that way. If you put your number plate on before you put your airlines on, which is kingpin, number plate, legs, brake, you can't check your lights, can you? Do you know what I mean? That's not good. So, I'll come back with you in a minute.
Right, if that can hear me.
You went on to bay 30, which is right inside of me. Now, I know the people that want to see me struggle doing this. I'm going to struggle doing this because there's two double stack trailers parked right in front of this bay, so it's going to be tight as a nun's chuff. And there's two thingies here as well, wagon drags. Wagon drags are longer than normal tugs, so there's even less frigging room. So I don't know how this is going to go down. I'm going to try my best, but you don't want to see me struggling to pop up. Well, this is probably going to go frigging wrong. I'll be very surprised if it doesn't. Plus, I've not been with one of these for don't know very long. And I don't even know where they're from. 30 years now, I've lost it. So, if I can actually get this one in one, or anything around about one, without smashing trailers and everything, didn't have fun.
License plate on again. I can't believe I've just got that on.
What, that is stupid. Oh man, that was ridiculous.
There's a trailer there. There's a trailer there. And a DHL park there. It's got room for another trailer inside of it. That was not skill. That was luck. Trust me. Trust me. That was luck. I'm impressed with that. And just to show you that wagon drags are longer than normal trucks. You know what I mean? They're about, what, 5 foot longer or so? So yeah, I'm actually quite impressed with that. I did that all right. I don't even care that I've got to climb underneath it, get me the thingy back. Pretty good, that. Pretty impressed. So, I've got to pick up this double decker now. And then make our way down to Dunstable. When we get down there, that's when I'll talk to you next. Okie smokey. Point number two coming up when we get down there. We'll put some music on now. Oh man, how many people recognise the tune from last week's vlog? Let the spirits high. I can't remember what it's called. If you're looking for trouble, how many of you remembered that tune? That is from the OG days, that is. That is from when I was doing class two on Fresh Direct. You know, I might go and do a week at Fresh Direct as well. I'm really tempted to go back there because I was mega that job.
really tempted to go back. Anyway, we'll get this trailer off. We've got to go over there to pick our double decker up. Got to go back in, get the paperwork, get the seal, and then I'll come back to you when we're getting down to Dunstable, which I'm hoping it's not going to be, you know, 3.5 hours. I'm hoping, because we've come an hour down, it might only be a 2 hour drive or 2.5 or so. But we'll see. We'll see anyway. I'll talk to you guys very shortly indeed. Peace out. If you can look into my eyes, you'd see what I am hypnotized. Oh, you get wrong with this siren high from all the things your dirty mind. Don't you wanna see what's deep inside? Then take it for a mighty ride. Oh, you get zoned from all fire and blind from all the things your dirty mind wants. Out of my mind, yeah, and get the hell low. Dig up your pride, babe, and let me know, no. You can see what I can see. The night is wild and so are we. Gents and ladies, since when did that become a word? With. What did that mean? Did-em. I've never heard that noise before. Don't know what that noise meant. Did-em. Anyone want to fill me in on that piece of information? Did-em. Anyway, we've made it. Ish. Nearly. Ugh. What a boring drive that one is, man. M6, M1. Oh, God, it's boring. Boring, man. It just seems to go on forever. What have we done? 3 hours? What did we do? We've got 51 minutes left. What does that mean? What's that mean in hours? I can't even think. I can't even think, Ben. No idea. 4.5 hours take 51. 30, 20. 3 hours and 40 minutes. Oh shit, I should have turned off there. That flipping flashy truck caught me eye then. It caught me eye and I thought, oh balls, I'm supposed to go down there. Oh, for God's sake. Flipping flapper flop. Balls that up. Again. As you do. Go on, Deedy lad. Anyway, we nearly made it. Without completely cocking everything up. We're getting there. So we're now in Dunstable. I think Dunstable's Luton. I think it's Luton Way. Not 100% sure. Yes, Luton, north. So we're there. Someone's going to say, you're about 27 miles away from Luton there, you fool. You're actually in Newcastle, you idiot. Well, my sat-nav don't tell me. It just says a road number. You need to slow down a bit, sunshine, and put an indicator on. So, we're here. Anyway, Dunstable, wherever that may be, Luton or whatever it is. We've had a catastrophe with the front camera. The front camera crashed, which is not good, because my second camera, the one that does the road footage, that is always crashing. So if I've got two cameras that are now crashing, YouTube becomes impossible. I can't do it, and I'm not replacing them. I point blank refuse to spend like 300 quid or whatever they were on cameras that don't even last 12 months. Fuming. So it crashed, so the time lapse might be a bit of absolutely pitch black darkness road that's not actually been recorded just yet. So you might have seen it and been like, wow, it went dark quick. Well, yeah, that might be the M1 going back home. Because I'm going to fill it in somewhere along the lines, aren't I? I can't have a... It crashed after 30 seconds. Quite brilliant, man. Awesome. Thanks for that. Nice one. So I can't put 30 seconds worth of a tune on, can I? Because I don't even get through chorus. So, anyway. Right. So, number two thing. I want to talk about. That people just do not seem to understand at all. These vlogs are for entertainment purposes. I act like a penis for your entertainment. This is HGV driving is the most boring job there is. It's damn close. It's damn close to being the most boring job ever. When I'm on night trunking, I literally drive somewhere, drop a trailer or get unloaded and reloaded, and then drive back, and that's it. And I make like an hour's worth of content out of this. Now, there's trampers out there that go away work all week and can only manage to put 12 minutes of content together, and 6 minutes of that's frigging time lapse. Do you know what I'm saying? If you like that kind of footage, if you like that kind of vlog, then crack on. If you don't like this, don't watch it. You know what I mean? But I try my best to make it as entertaining for you lot as I can. I try to put a little bit of educational stuff in there, but the way that I act and all that stuff, I'm doing it mainly for camera, for trying to make you smile. If you meet me in person, I'm not actually a complete and utter freak. I'm genuinely not. I'm rather normal. It's just when I'm on a camera, if I just said to you, hey guys, today we're going down to Dunstable, then we're going to swap trailers, and then we're going to drive back up to Middlewich, we're going to swap trailers, and then we're going to go back to Oldham, where we're going to drop the trailer, and then we're finished. So on Monday I went to Dunstable, and Tuesday I went to Dunstable, and Wednesday I had a change and went to Gateshead. You'd be like, really? I ain't watching this, dude. Do you know what I mean? That'd be poo. So I've got to make a bit of fun about myself and maybe other people and whatnot. I have to do it. So please, will you just understand, when you're watching me, if you're watching me for the entertainment purpose, you already know, but it's just entertainment. It's just to try and have a little bit of a laugh, to try and lighten the mood, take the piss out of myself, and have a bit of a laugh and a joke. Because this job is boring. There's no to talk about. I've got to make up stuff to talk about to keep you guys occupied. And that's what a lot of people agree that I do. But there's some people that just don't seem to get it, that seem to think that I am an absolute bam pot. When I'm not, I'm pretty damn good at my job. Do you know what I mean? When I'm in the truck on my Todd, I'm not like, you know, licking windows, right, like that. I'm decent at my job. That's why agencies hire me. That's why people keep asking me for me to go back, because I'm good at what I do. I just, when I put a camera on, I have a bit of a laugh. So, them are the two. I think there's other things I wanted to talk about as well, but I just can't remember. I really can't remember. But them are the two main things you need to understand. I'm on an agency. I drive for different companies. I want to be on an agency because I like the variety. And the second thing is these vlogs, they're for entertainment purposes. If you don't find them entertaining, don't watch them. You know, I act up for the camera to try and entertain you guys. That's what I want to do on a Friday. If you're all in and you're not doing anything and you like truck vlogs, I like to be able to give you an hour's worth of entertainment that you can sit down with a can of whatever you want, curling, if you're really that way inclined, a rattler, so you can sit down with a can, put your feet up and unwind, and maybe have a little bit of a chuckle at my expense. Do you know what I'm saying? That's the be all and end all of it, basically. There's just some people just do not get it. But as we've said before, tis what tis. Some people never understand. But there you go. I've tried explaining it best I can. I can't go any more into detail than that. I am afraid to say. But we are nearly here now. So when this is done, I can actually talk about my weekend. and what I did last week and where I ended up and how I ended up in front of a frigging nuclear reactor or something. Christ. I took pictures of him, put it on my Instagram. You really need to be following me on Instagram at DD2012. You really do. If you look straight in front of you now, I don't know if you'll be able to see it on this camera, straight in front where that white hall is, I've got to reverse this double-decker into that hall. But, like I said, that guy is going to get there before me. Frig. So I've got to wait for him now to do one. I've got to wait for him to be loaded before I can be unloaded, which is a bit poo, but... Oh, I don't know. Like I say, tis what tis. So, I'll get out of the road and get down hither and try not to bash anything with anything. There we go. We're in, sorted. So, I just sit here and wait now until he comes out and then I go in. So I'm going to put it on break and hopefully get a 15. And then when I go in there, I can just have an half an hour. But let me talk to you about something else. I want to talk to you about this. Seriously. The newest flavour of Y food that I can finally show you. This is mango. Right now, I couldn't resist. I love mango. I couldn't resist. I've already had 5 of them. This is the last one. I had to save this one to show you. You can buy this now as a single. You can't buy it in this way. You can't buy it as in the starter pack. You can buy it as a single. If you want to try Y food and you're still umming and ahhing, you might think it's a bit expensive, but it's not, because it's a meal replacement shake. Try the mango one. Honestly, this is the best flavour that they've made. It is absolutely ridiculous. It is on another level, this flavour. It's unbelievable. That's why I've already had 5 of them. Oh, man. Seriously, I'm not even joking. You know, people still keep messaging me, asking me about Y food. Do you actually really drink it? Yeah, I have at least one a day, and I've got my kids on it now as well. Because my kids love it. And sometimes at weekend, they just can't be arsed eating. They're too busy. They're playing or whatever. So I just chuck them a bottle of Y food. Big D has coconut. He loves that one. Lucas has coffee. He likes that one. It's got caffeine in it, but whatever. He loves that one. And Ava Jean has mixed berries. She loves it. So I'll chuck them a Y food for the dinner. If they can't be arsed stopping and they want to run around like lunatics, then give them a Y food. It keeps them full and it doesn't make them sick either. D had one before he went to football on Saturday, and it didn't make him feel sick or nothing. He said that he felt absolutely fine. So definitely good for all the family. I think everyone should have a Y food on them at all times, just in case. I was in a mega bad rush this afternoon because I've been busy and I didn't even have time to prep my food. So obviously Y food in the bag, don't need to be refrigerated. 27 multivitamins and minerals, 26 sorry, multivitamins and minerals, rich in protein, lactose free, gluten free. You know, look at all them multivitamins and minerals in that. Really good for you. Unfortunately, this is in German, because when they sent me these, they weren't out in the UK. So it's in German, so I can't really translate. I forgot. Still 500 calories per bottle. It's dead easy to fit into your dieting regime. I think that's carbohydrates. 38 grams of carbs. Belting. Protein. Is that protein? No. I don't know what protein is on there. 35, I think. I think there's 35 grams of protein in it. Absolutely banging. If you really want to try a Y food, you want to just buy one. Buy the mango one and try it. It is absolutely phenomenal. So yeah, and use DD10 at checkout and you'll get 10% off. That code doesn't benefit me. I don't get anything from that code. I'm on a fixed fee. So it's for your benefit only. But I'm telling you, this mango is off the chart. They've absolutely nailed it with this one. Oh yeah, and the missus likes hazelnut as well. She loves that one. She said it was dead good. So yeah. Belted, why food, DD10.
So
we're gonna sit here. We're gonna have a 15. I don't know what I'm gonna do. Because when you get in there's no signal. So yeah. I'll show you me reversing in there. I don't get any unloaded footage, I don't see anything. We'd park on a bay. We're back in. A guy stops us before we actually get there. Cuts the thingamajig off at the back, the seal, opens the doors for us, and then we back onto the bay. He tells us when to stop. Simple as that. So that's what we'll do. And then I'll put my camera on charge so it doesn't die again, because it's only on about 20-something%. It looks dead low. Put my camera back on charge, and then I'll get back with yous when we probably get back up to Middlewich, and we can see if we can nail this double decker on a bear. So it's all fun and games. What time actually is it? Shall I do us a nice curry for tea tomorrow? I'll need to nip to the shop. That's if you want it. Shall we have a nice curry for tea tomorrow? I ain't never gonna say no to a curry. It's 10 to 11, by the way. It has seemed to have taken us forever to get down here. Oh, so it took us, what, 5 hours from starting to get down here? 6 to 11, 5 hours. So we've got to get tipped. Just call it an hour, 6 hours. And then 4 hours get back. I think, yeah. An hour here, 10 to 11, 10 to 12. 4 hours get back, 4 o'clock. Hopefully, fingers crossed, get in bed for 5. Anyway, I'm going. You'll see me in a minute when I'm reversing this humongous thing in there. I'm going to put a picture on Instagram of it now. So if you follow me at DD2012, you'd see it, wouldn't you? I'm going. Shush. Off. Because it is stupid o'clock. We'll see if we can stick this in a little hole. So first part of this manoeuvre is proper guesswork. I ain't got a clue where that hole is. I'm just going to swing it around there and see where it ends up. Do you know what I'm saying? Bro? We'll just keep a nice gentle curve on the trailer. Just a nice gradual, curve, and then it all goes 90 degrees. Then. That's when we get that bus. I don't even know which hole I'm going in. I've not got a driver door, I'm not even lying. So we just stay in front of the middle. Just wait in front of the middle and see where that's at. There's one we're going in. Good. Oh, it's good. I have balls, by the way. I bring it out there, mate. Oh, get me hands on it. Look at that. Oosh. Oosh. He said warp, that means you flicked it up. I'm gonna do it again. Just because of that. Just because my name's Deedy, I'm there to do it again, because that was just absolutely okay. Couldn't see nothing. Okay, where are we going? Let's get in the middle of that concrete line this time and not on the thing here. So we've got more stuff again. Come on. Come on, man. Come on, NAN. What's that done? I'm like an amateur. Hey, I'm not usually this bad. Honest. Shit, me, I'm funny. I don't know what's going on. Miles out. Thank you. I'm going to show you this because that is the worst reverse I have ever done in my entire natural life. That is absolutely horrendous. But honestly, it does happen sometimes. You just can't reverse. You just cannot do it for top two. Unbelievable. See how still up steel. Seriously was the the worst reverse maneuver ever. Oh, and I'm gonna leave that in. So you can just see how bad you can't really cock it up. That was horrific, Bob. Oh, I'm gonna blame it on the triaxle. That's what I'm blaming. I'm blaming it on three wheels. Six wheels at back. Oh my lord. That really was proper shocking, though, wasn't it? Oh, God. We're in. It don't matter. We're in. Oh, no. Oh, man. Right, we're in. That's all I've got to say about that. We've made it. God. So, we'll sit here now for half an hour or so. Get loaded. Get unloaded, then get reloaded with stock to take back north. Then we'll go to Middlewich where we... Oh, Christ, have I got to put this damn thing on a bay after that? Oh, man. Yeah. Get up to Middlewich, drop this off, pick up an empty single decker and take it back. Oh, yeah, just so you know. I have actually changed the height mark of 16.3, just so you know. Yeah, back up to Middlewich, swap trailers for a single empty, take it back to Oldham, and then we're done. And we're done for tonight. So, I'll leave you there while we get unloaded. There's no signal in here, unfortunately. So, I can't even play on my phone. What the hell is that? Don't sound good, does it? Coming from a truck, man. I don't know. Yeah, so come back with you when we get back up to Middlewich Way, and then we can have a proper chat about what's really been going on. Speak to you soon. All right, gents and ladies, we have finally come off the M6. What an absolute slog that was. My God. I'm not gonna lie, I had to buy a coffee and pull over and have a 15 minute kip because my eyes were getting very heavy. Oh, God. It seems to have taken for absolute ever to get here. It's been shocking. Shocking, man. I cannot wait to get in bed. And it's 3:15. I've got another hour to get back up to Old Rochdale, Oldham, Milnrow, Milne Road. I've got another hour to get back up to there, and I've got to do a trailer swap yet. So I'm not looking to get in until 4 o'clock, half four, half five. I'm not looking to get in until about half five. Ooh! Long for me, that. Long night. Criminy. I'm poo-fagged, man. Ready for bed. Really want to go to bed. But anyway, this weekend, man, jeez, I got let down on Friday by two different people. Not happy at all. I hate being let down. I hate it when someone says they'll do something and then they don't. It drives me absolutely insane. We had something planned for 3 weeks. Supposed to be going to Stoke, as I told y'all. And decided 2 days beforehand to scrap it off. No, I've got other arrangements. Alright, sweet, nice one. Belling. So I asked another lad to come out. Yeah, definitely. Well up for that. Yeah, definitely, definitely. Waits until the actual day and then says, oh, sorry, mate, I might be working. Oh, God, it. Fucking, God, it frustrates me when people do that. If you're going to say you're doing something, do it. Simple as. So I asked Steph, the guy that brought me them rattlers, I asked him, I just said, he lives local. I said, do you fancy a couple of pints? He said, I'm not going to have too many. Because obviously I got baby and whatnot. Just have a couple. I said, yeah, all right then, we'll go to pub and have a couple of pints and then, you know, whatever. Go on. Yeah, all right. So we goes into the first pub, has a couple of pints. Where shall we go now? We'll go to Barley. Goes into Barley, has a couple of pints, couple of shots. Met Crazy Kim. Kim's absolutely doolally. Let's go in Spoons, shall we? Yeah, go on then. Went in Spoons. Funny story in Spoons. There were three of us. And this waitress come over. And this lad asked for a number. She said, can I get you anything? And he said, six bottles of Bud. And your number. And she went, well, I'm not allowed to give you my number, but I finish at 1:30. And he went, right, I'll wait for you at 1:30. And she blushed and walked off. Little did we know, her fellow was sat on the next table to us, literally like 6 feet away. This scrawny little 6-stone piss wet through lad, and he went following her, and we listened to what he was saying. He was like, I'm going to be outside of here at 1:30 to pick you up. You won't be going anywhere fucking near them. What are you doing talking to people like that? What are you doing telling them what time you finish? I'm going to be here at 1:30. I says, got anything to say, just come and say it to us, man. You know what I mean? It's not as if we're going to take offence if he turns around and says, hey, listen, mate, she's taken. Do you know what I mean? The absolute lunatic. So, that never happened anyway. Nothing come of it. And then we ended up going into this bloody nightclub thing. Christ. 5 o'clock in the morning I rolled in. We were only going out for a couple. What a night. It was actually belting, to be fair. It was proper fun. But only going out for a couple and strolling in at 5 o'clock is not good. I was three sheets to the wind, I tell you. Oh, it's Richie. Mr. Mulgrew Richie. Yo, dude. Yeah, I wasn't in a very fit state on Saturday, let's just be honest. I was absolutely gopping. Horrible. Oh, gates are locked. Oh, frig. I'm going to have to ring number now. Oh, balls. Is he going to walk down here and let me in? Is that Mr. Security Guy? Mr. Security Guy's over there, I think. Is he? Is not he? Is he? Is not he? He is. He's coming. Yeah! He's coming for let us in. So this trailer's empty. There's nothing in it. All they did was empty me and then said you can go. I was like, oh, sweet.
So we're just going to dump it in here somewhere and then pick up a little one and bugger off home, and let's hope it's plain sailing this, because I just want to go home and go to bed. I'm knackered, and I'm supposed to be training with two lads that I met on Friday. Tomorrow I'm supposed to be going to a different gym. I'm not training at Pure anymore. So, oh sugar, harmony. Yeah, I'm supposed to be training at a proper bodybuilding gym. That's all they say. So we'll see how that goes. Fingers crossed it's good, so I can go more often, because there's like nothing at all for legs apart from squats at Pure gym. Nothing. But I could go to the Pure in Widnes, I suppose. Pay an extra £5 a month and go to any Pure gym. Could do that. I don't know, we'll see. What's the point in locking gear? It's not as if I'm just about to tear ass through and smash everything up. You know what I mean? Let's see if he can just let me straight in. Alright, mate, it's an empty trailer this. I'm only I'm dropping it off and taking an empty one back.
Oh, okay, mate.
Alright, mate. I don't really think that had the response that I was expecting. I don't really kind of know what I was expecting, but please don't shut that gate to the back of me, because I don't live here and I'm not staying here. I just want to be on my way and go home. It means he's going to have to come back out to let me in. Oh, shucks. Right, so I'm going to go down there. I'll show you reversing this, unhitching it as I do. And then, yeah. Someone said to me, put a light on your catwalk so we can see what you're doing. And that light, it's on the catwalk. So that's what I'm going to do. I'll unhitch it and then we'll pick up the other trailer. I'll speak to you in a second. Right. Stick it. I'm going to take that one back. Oh, shucks. I was going to stick it there. Well, now I'm not. Because there's a drag in the way. So I'm going to stick it next to VOR over yonder, methinks. Oh, man. I hope you can see with the head cam. I'll put in the camera on the windscreen, on the wing mirror for this. Let's go. Let's go back forwards. Let's aim for line. Not in that cage, maybe. Possibly. Possibly not hit that cage. Let's start turning a little bit sooner than what we usually do and see if it'll come round straight. What do you think the chances are? No. Naysville. Naysville is the answer. Oh, a little better than usual. Better than usual. Hey. Oops. Better than usual, are you mad? What are you smoking? That'll do. That will do nicely. Call that quits. Put this light on so they can sit. So they can see what they're doing. Leave the engine on. There's that noise again. Hoddum, hoddum. Don't know what it is. Hoddum, hoddum. Right, let's go and unhitch a roof. Fuel. So, first things first, we pull brake. And brake, pull brake. And then, there we go. So with this handle, pull it all the way out. It's gonna, you know, floppy didgery. if you hold the bolt, I mean, you probably can't see what I'm doing, but if you hold the screw that goes through it, pull the screw towards you, but push the handle in, it'll lock in place like that. So if it's a dodgy handle that wobbles and stuff, you can just wind it like that. But if you push the entire bolt in like that, you engage the low ratio thing. So like, if you need to wind it up when it's loading or whatever, it does that, which does proper slow. So pull it out, but then push the bolt back in, and it'll go down nice and bunny. Just because the handle's dead dodgy on this. And then, on the bearing, I'll adjust a bit. Right. I'm gonna take my number plate off now because I'm closest at the back, why not? Thanking you. Oh, holy stupid. Back up here. Don't shout at me. Don't come and shout at me. I've not done anything wrong. Hey, look at this. Shining some light on the situation. Oh, look at this. This is just an unmitigated disaster. Oh, man. Hello.
Trailer, mate,
take
you back. Just around the corner there, yeah?
Right, okay. I'm not Chad, the trailer I'm taking back is just round the corner. Really? Excuse me. Really? Oh! It smells like pumping here. There's that noise again. Hoddam, hoddam. I have no idea what that noise is. Right, so, I put my gadget on. We're gonna unclick. There's that noise again. The hell is it? We're going to unclick, so it clicks, and then drop our air out of it, so that you don't bang it on its knees. Get out. Lovely. Put ride out back up. Come on, go up. And our trailer is round the corner, is it now? Is it really? This is a one-way street, I'm sure it is. I'm sure this is a proper strict one-way system. Ah, yeah, proper strict. Ah, so it is. 529. Okay. I'm gonna have to do a reverse spinny to get to it. Got to do a spinny. Oh, you frigger, I'm not going to be able to do it. Oh, I really wanted to do that then as well. Damn you. That would have been well cool. A reverse spinny. Righty ho. I start dropping the air out. No. Stuff it. And we'll go back, Vads. PHB 529. Sweet. Speed bump. Pom pom. Oosh. 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 Suspension up. Up, 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 up. We've got it. We're under it. Click into place. Bosh. Tug F, test F. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Handbrake, neutral, turn that off for now. Right. We're gonna pick this up. We're gonna change our right meter to 13.10 in it, this one. But we'll leave our sat nav at 16.3 because I've changed it to 16.3. And that's it. That's gonna be the end of the video for this one. Because I'm knackered and I just want to go home, I'm not going to lie. I want to go home to bed. I am poo-fagged. Listening to a bit of Rush on my own. So, thank you so much for joining me on another night shift. I hope I've cleared a couple of things up for a few people. If you've enjoyed what you've seen, click that subscribe button, click the thumbs up, follow me on Instagram, follow me on TikTok, do whatever you want. It's your life. Thanks so much for watching. My name's Didi. I'm just a dickhead that drives a truck and I record myself doing so. Take it easy, people. Thank you so much for watching. Take care. Stay safe. See you soon.